Do you love to find the motives which doesn't even exist? Do you love to find the secrets behind an eye? Do you love to see something dark and something silent?
So I, Mr. Anant, invites you to experience a world of silence, a world of corruption, a world of darkness, a world of the passion of Joan of Arc.
And here we go.
Number 1. Camera movement. Well, as we can see, the camera shot which is taken here is a B-roll shot, but above the level of human height.
Well, this can be signified in two ways. First, the level of Joan is very down. Second, the director wants to show the scene from the perspective of God. So remember, if you want to take a B-roll shot with multiple advantages and wants audience to see from various perspective, then write the script which is dependent on the mechanism of camera movements.
Number 2. Emotions.
This picture shows the crying Joan. She has a bittersweet emotion and subtle in her eyes. Looking at the facial lines, feel like she wanted to say something but couldn't due to some reasons. And this picture shows the judge's smirk. This shot makes the viewer think that the person is happy by seeing Joan getting tortured. He seems to be well planned and knows everything beforehand and even knows how is it going to end. He must have won a debate most probably with Joan. Well, we can call the whole scene as the true estimate. For example, when you toss a coin and the head comes, then according to the true estimate, you can say it is not a tail. Similarly, here when the judge smirk, you can automatically say that the director wants to show the scene of the crying Joan.
Number 3. Motives. Well, director Carl Theodor is amazing in using the motives in his films.
Some symbols in the film that stood out were the crown men placed on Joan's head, resembling the crown of thorns placed on Jesus' head, because he was the king of the Jews. Now let's come to the critical and creative questions. So the first question is, am I the only one who see the subtitles in French? Let me wear the specs. Why is she told to be dressed like woman so many times? Well, this portrays male chauvinism, which means a male who patronizes, disparages, or otherwise denigrates female in the belief that they are inferior to males and thus deserving of less than equal treatment or benefits. Let's move on to the second question. What is the significance of a fly that has been shown in few of the scenes? In certain cultures, flies are related with demonic possessions. Joan is a pious saint and she's amidst the evil judges who are trying to influence her into belief that she's not a saint. Here, fly personifies by the evil. Let us hear the views of some amazing people on the passion of Joan of Arc.
Danish director Dreyer, who had toyed with projects concerning Marie Antoinette or Catherine de' Medici, spent 18 months researching transcripts of Joan of Arc's trial by the English in the early 15th century. To lend authenticity to her imprisonment, he built vast concrete sets more costly than any previous European production. And to ensure that Joan's pain was experienced and understood by the audience, he got Falconetti to kneel for hours on cold concrete floors and then instructed her to wipe any expression from her face.
Studios in Berlin destroyed the original painting. There's only a couple of copies of that negative. And Those were thought to be lost for over 50 years until one was found in a janitor's closet in a mental institution in Oslo, Norway.
So The Passion of Joan of Arc is an amazing art piece in the world of cinema. The link of trailer, screenplay and film is given in the description. Go and watch the film right now. So see ya, have a good day. This is Mr. Anand and you are Open World. Bye-bye.